that shrouded it was history, forgotten to everyone but we. Standing barefoot amidst tree stumps with dead soil between our toes, not a bird for a thousand miles to nest in the nothingness the loggers left behind. There was a time when the sun still shone upon a canopy of light, when the wind rustled through leaves upon which caterpillars crawled and pine needles scented the air, now arid in the desolation wrought by corporations that consumed until there was nothing left to destroy. There was a time when we were still free to shape the path that would lead us forward, when we still had the strength to choose our trajectory and not be dragged by it toward our demise, reeled in mercilessly like a fish with a hook in its mouth when all it was seeking was sustenance, a need which in its innocence ignited the engine of this terrible machine, leveling everything sacred to the ground as if in one fell swoop, unfolding in the slow motion that is our lives, our reactions to our actions retarded by the molasses that is our unrighteous comforts. And yet we can do better than this, and we've perceived it in the eyes of children singing and rolling off the tongues of elders whose gardens grow, just as their memories know that all is not lost, even if everything has been taken, for we have each other and a purpose therein. But the mountain is steep and tall and the ground is weak, and with every step we take, the land gives out where tree roots once secured it. The forest is dying, and so are we. And without the lungs of our planet, soon enough we will